We're back here at Evergreen Speedway for the sixth round of Formula Drift. We finished here in third place last year. We're back at it again to hopefully stand on top of the podium. For the first practice session, I feel like I was lacking in the areas of confidence, commitment, and that's only because in our previous round in Canada, we hit the wall hard and really jacked up the frame rails. Even throughout the first practice session, we made constant changes to the suspension, the dampening, and with the help from Chris at KW, we were able to improve the car to the point where I was feeling a little bit more confident, but still, I feel like I was lacking the commitment, especially on entry and outer zone two to the first inside clip, and then crossing the second inside clip to the finish line is where Ben had told me I needed to work on specifically. So it's Friday, it's qualifying day today here in Seattle. And one thing I'm gonna tell you guys is it is hot. I expected nice, cool, breezy weather wearing sweaters and jackets and long pants, but it is about 95 degrees here. Totally unexpected, and I really don't think this is the typical Seattle weather. So the weather has definitely caught all of us off guard, and it is not your typical cold, crispy Seattle weather. But the first thing that happened right when practice started was we blew up our differential, and that rarely happens. In fact, it's our first incident with the differential throughout the whole season in 2017, and you know, that sort of put us in a delay going into practice, but my team worked really hard, really quick to swap the diff, and we made it back into practice with about an hour to spare. In the very last round of practice, I was in the chase lap, and I knew this was probably going to be my last lap, so I would try to simulate a tandem battle situation. Leading the run was Jonathan Castro. I wanted to see how we would stack up against his speed. Unfortunately, before inside clip number two, before the finish line, after transition, I couldn't get the nose to dive in, and I ended up going straight into Castro's bumper, with the bumper being dragged under my car and then pulling into the pits with a furious-looking Benji Cimino. First run now, I was a little nervous because we only had about two solid runs before the actual qualifying run. I think I realized this round especially that if you're a low ranked driver, you have to go off first and sort of set the standard, and puts us in a really challenging situation because even if we pull off a really good badass run, you know, they have to adjust their standard scoring system. So going against the top qualifiers or the top ranked drivers brings us at a disadvantage because by the time they come up, they sort of forget about our run and the scores keep getting higher. So we really have to nail the second run, push harder. Unfortunately, I had a little mishap with the shifter and I had to sit with an 85, so which put us in 14th place.